Good morning, my disowned inbred prince of Persia. How are we feeling today? I feel honestly nice and positive. We're feeling good. You get as if get yourself a child in the intensive care unit and then you'll have a sense of being able to view life differently. So we had, this is a bit personal, but we went for a much more natural birth option. So home birth and choosing not to bathe him for a week so that the fluid that's on him can like absorb into his skin. It's meant to be very good for the babies. But he got a bath last night, and since I was at home, Shay was at the hospital, she sent me videos of it. He just looked like he was enjoying it. She sent me a photo of him with like a hot towel on his head, just spa day. But I think you have to see the good sides in things. But it's like something like this has, I don't know the right way to put it, given me the opportunity to have a bit more, to be less hyper-focused on the thing that I'm doing. Like it's, in my position now, I look back on when I started doing this storytelling content, and a video could take me like 3-4 hours. And it's this Dunning-Kruger effect. If you don't know it, I'll show you when I get home. This Dunning-Kruger effect, looks like I'm going through a red, but I'll just talk about it when I draw it at home. But having so much information, learning so much about storytelling, I'd gotten myself into a place where like I expected to be doing so much in a video, and that was actually stopping me from being more productive, making more, doing more experiences, and enjoying myself more. I did enjoy it, but it also felt like there was a lot of pressure on making sure I make a video that hits everything perfectly and hits millions of views versus, you know, what I'm doing this for to begin with, which is to enjoy it. I think I also realized that last night I was talking about a cold creator versus a warm creator. I don't know if I really shared my kind of game plan in that. So I guess we established that like this content here is warm creator content, where it feels more friendly, more personal, more real. It feels like a porthole into someone. Whereas the cold creator content is like something that's made purely for entertainment. Anyway, how I'm going to start to like utilize what I'm thinking as like what I can do on TikTok to be more real is, take like film the thing that I want to do as if I was just filming it for this, and then chop up and take out the least important parts, the bits that don't need to be in there, because obviously you're still playing somewhat of a retention game on TikTok. You can't have the long pauses that we have here. You can't have too much repetition. It needs to be fairly straightforward, I think, because I haven't done videos over a minute before, so it'll be interesting to see. And then we got some fun stuff to do with Rugi. So let's go and check out the Dunning-Kruger effect and show how that kind of paralyzes you in whatever you're doing. Yeah. Well, we are going back to the gym because I left my bag there. I planned on showering at the gym, and then I remembered that Rugi would probably want to. So like, it's nice to have those like little bonding experiences. So I'm going back to the gym to get my bag, which is kind of stupid, isn't it? So let's just talk about the Dunning-Kruger effect now. Essentially, you have a graph where you start off, someone finds a subject or a topic, they're very interested in it, and they start learning bits about it. And you get this increasingly high confidence because you've gone from zero to some level of knowledge, and you feel like you know so much about the topic. Now, this is really dangerous when you, like, if you're that person, you've found a new topic, you've done some research on it, you now think you know a bit, and you go into conversation with someone who is, like, let's say an expert in that, or knows a lot about that, has been that for a long time, you very quickly realize that you don't know anything. And it's very easy to tell with the people that think they know a lot about a topic, like the people that think they're experts about a topic, are 99% of the time going to be the people who have really only just started learning it. And then the true experts, the people who really know the information, they have a really good understanding of what they don't know. So the graph goes, it shoots up, and then it has a significant drop off, and slowly, like really slowly, before coming all the way down, begins to turn itself around and slowly increase. So you think you know everything, and then you have some sort of reality check and you realize, oh my gosh, I know so little about this, whatever I'm talking about, and you drop all the way down. And now you're on this crazy curve to try and come back up, where you start to understand, or you start to see, or you start to believe in your mind that, or understand that you don't know what you don't know. You see that this topic you thought you know a ton about has actually got so much to it, and you're just at the very bottom trying to work your way up. And so I felt that I was given some advice when I, like, closer to when I started doing these videos, and it was, be more confident, like, talk as if you are the expert, like, speak in declaratives. And it's just wrong, because I don't know, like, the things that I'm pretty, like, I'm almost certain of the answers of, I will speak in declaratives, I'll make those as statements. But for the most part, I'm still learning. Like, I'm still testing, I'm still trial and erroring. Like, I'm not, in terms of, like, let's say, there are lots of different types of content, right? There's, like, content to entertain, there's content to educate, there's content to sell. I wouldn't say that I'm a good salesman by any stretch. I might be a half-decent salesman in terms of showcasing a fun or an interesting way to use a product or a service, but I'm certainly not, you could not put me outside knocking on someone's door saying, here's a great product, this is what it can do for you, blah blah blah. Even that is just a terrible sales technique. And, like, I really, across the whole spectrum of what you could do with content creation, I'm in a very small slither of that, which honestly scares me. So when I talk about changing my content style, it scares me. It's like being in your job, getting, like, having a good idea of what you're doing, getting really good job reports, like your manager's telling you how well you're doing. So in that case, like in this case, it would be high view counts, good engagement rate. And then the next day you come into work and you're like, you know what, I kind of want to change how I do this. And I have no idea if my manager is going to look at this and think I've done a really good job, or they're going to look at me and say, this is crap. What the hell are you doing? Why did you change what worked? And it's down to fulfillment. Like, how do I feel about making the videos that I'm making? And I mentioned last night, like, this type of content, now I have it in my armory. It doesn't mean that I've been doing it wrong all this time and I can throw it out the window. I've learned a lot from it and I can improve on it. Where was I going with that? But I've realized that the reason, I mentioned this a few times, the reason I'm not really building any kind of community is because I'm that cold creator. Like, people can see from the outside that it's just a guy making a video for entertainment, when all the time in my mind, it's been trying to share more to be that. What I didn't realize was a warm creator, but I just got mixed up in it, and I'm gonna go get my bag. I guess today's probably not a good day to listen to me because my bag was still in the car. So here's what's happened. I've decided I'll take my bag to the gym to shower. I've gotten here, decided I won't shower at the gym. I'll shower at home with Rugi. So I haven't taken it in. Obviously, I thought I've taken it in. Gone to the gym. I've forgotten to bring my bag out of the gym. Drive home. Get pretty much home and realize I've forgotten my bag at the gym. Come back to the gym. Tell the front desk, sorry, I just forgot my bag. That's fine. Go and get it. I'm looking in every locker that I could have put it in. I'm moving people out the way. I'm saying sorry. I'm being awkward. And I'm stood there. And I'm using Find My iPhone to try and figure out where my AirPods case is. And you can't find the case from it. So I'm like, well, there's no way I actually left it in the car. I'm pretty sure I made this decision while I was working out that I wouldn't shower at the gym. Nope, it's in the car. It's in the car the whole time. So, yeah, maybe listening to me for advice in the current state is not ideal. But I guess in my content, I think I've come to realize that I want to focus on the feel. I'll finish this thought. I want to focus on the feeling in things, like how do I feel at the beginning and how does doing something affect the way I feel? I think that's quite a cool way to look at it. And then I forgot the other thought that I was going to go on. Oh gosh. Type of content, feeling. It's gone. Lost it. I just sat here for a good minute or so thinking, so I cut that out. I didn't cut that out. This is me, like, trying to think about the edit. I don't know what it was, so Dunning-Kruger effect now. Right, little man is floating around somewhere. Oh, there he is. What are you doing? All right, first up, mix up the pancake mix. Rugi, do you want to help? Yeah, you want to help? Yeah, you want your tower? Yeah, you do. We've got a bowl over here. Dude, this thing, well, I was about to sing its praises. It's good, but I think he's just too mental to have any desire to stay on it. Like, that was a cheese grater. Why does he have a cheese grater? Do you want to pick out your favorite colors? Yeah, you can choose 5 colors. Gone. Nope. All right, let's use, Shay normally uses the Kodiak. She normally uses this one. But this one's also to use up. Rugi, can you pour this in? Thank you. Keep pouring. Good job. Keep going. Like, I love this. Like, thinks he's helping. He's got no idea. Yeah, let's just stick your dirty hand in there. Nice. Oh, no, don't. No. Don't eat that yet. Yet. Okay, let's see if... Oh, cool. Coming out the box. Dude. Oh, well. Let's stop eating that, okay? Well, you're a bit of a mess, aren't you, sausage? Get some water. Ruger, it's not ideal that you just then... Okay. You little sicko. This... I have a newfound... What is it? What's wrong? You want to mix? Oh, of course, sorry. Mix it. No. What? Baby? What did you say? Yeah, this is gross. You don't eat this, Ruger. We have to cook it first. So, I don't know if I even told you what the plan is here. We're going to make, with the different colors, make different colored pancakes. And hopefully it'll be fun for him to... Yeah, you want to mix? Mix, mix, mix. Mix, mix, mix. No. Go mix it. Put some elbow into it, dude. Oh, actually, you like using the blender, don't you? Do you want to use the blender? Yes. Okay, let's pour this into here. Okay. I think... This might actually be better this way. Might be easier to blur his face when I'm editing. Okay, can you hold this steady? Good job, hold it there. Don't move it. Nice. Like Oliver Twist's slop. Okay, good boy, leave it there. Okay, let me make some more. And then you can blend it. Be careful, those are ouchies. Yeah. Okay, hold on. All right, you wanna put the lid on?
Yes.
Okay, come around here. All right, screw the lid on. Good job, all right, now twist. Twist, twist, twist. Twist it. Other way. He's pretty good at twisting things off. Not fantastic about twisting them on. Are you? You've got to start somewhere, haven't you? Okay. Good job. Do you want to do the blending? Okay, let me bring this over. Now, when we blend, Mr. Ruger, we always put our fingers in it. All right, put it here and I'll move you over a bit. Okay, it doesn't go any further. You put that down there, and then you grab this, put it on top. Good job. Okay, twist, twist, twist. All right, now push, push. Oh, yeah. Nice. You did it. All right, that's nicely mixed. Okay, is that mixed well? Did you mix it well? Well done. All right, now we'll start to put this into different bottles. All right, so this one can go into here, and then you need to pick a color. Okay. What color do you want this to be? What color do you want? Red? Oh, okay. Go on then. Can you open it? Just, if you want some help, you know what to say. You want some help? Okay, good boy. Okay, this is going to be, I'm sure this is going to be very red. So you're going to squeeze that into here, okay? Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Oh, okay, let's do some more. Like this. Okay, grab it. Hold on. Okay. So grab it like this. And then, squeeze. Oh, good job. Do you want to put the lid on? No, this lid. Well, this is going to be a slow process. Maybe I'll turn this off for the moment. Dude. Yeah, that's not a straw. All right, put the... Okay, I'll help you with this bit. Because otherwise we're going to be eating this for breakfast next Tuesday. All right, shake. Shake, please. Shake, shake, shake. Look at the colour. Don't drink it. Rugi, look at the colour. Look at the bottle. Whoa! Oh, funny thing, the barbecue bottles that I found were actually cheaper than non-barbecue, barbecue bottles. So I got these. What color do you want to do next? Can you pick out a blue? Where's a blue color? It was me saying what, okay, we'll go with that one. You want help opening? Okay. Yeah, you gonna squirt some in? Okay. Do you remember how? Good job. Oh, nice. Okay, so you wanna do the, what color do you wanna do next? What color is that? What color is that? That's brown. You sure you wanna do brown? That's pretty boring, Rugs. A bit more, hold on. I'll go and get it. I'll get it. Shake this one for me, please. Can you shake it? Okay. What color? Wait. No, don't drink that. What color should we do next? Pick a good color. What color do you want? What color do you want to do? Rugi, pick a colour. Do you want that one? Okay, can you open it for me, please? Do you want help? Okay. Wait, can you shake that, please? Shake it hard, really hard. Don't drink it, or just... Shake, shake, shake. Shake, shake, shake. I said, shake, 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 shake it, shake, shake, shake. I'm gonna make some more of this. You wanna pick out your next color, Rugi? No, Ruga. Dude. What color do you wanna do next? Pick a color, please. Rugi, stop. That's gross. That's so gross. You're sick. Stop. Stop drinking that. That's nasty. You're a nasty baby. You're a nasty baby. Stop. Dude. Ew. Ew. Dude, that's enough. You want some more pancake mix? Yes. No. Pick out another color. Please. All right. Nope, nope, nope. Where do you want to go? It's like if anyone ever said to me, Oliver, I'm pretty sure you don't have ADHD, I think at this point I would just say, would you like to take one look at my child? What do you want? No, you're not getting up there yet. Because, Ruby, this is hot. That's ouchies. We've got to stay away from that. That's ouchies. Can you use the blender for me? Good boy. Okay. Okay, get ready. Where is it? Here it is. All right, stick it in there. Good job. Right, now push, 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 push. Nice. Good job. Is it done? All done. Is it done?
No.
No, it doesn't need any more. Stay down. We're going to fill up these two bottles. And you're going to use green. I knew making these videos would be tough. Oh gosh. It's a little on the watery side. Let's put some more mix in there. I need you to blend this again, Rugi. Can you blend it again for me? Thank you. Okay, hold on. Yes. You want to put some in there? Okay. We need to finish doing this first. All right. You want to do it? All right, push, push, push. Nice. I think that's still too watery. Let me put some more in. Are you going to make the best pancakes ever? Are you going to tell Mummy that you made pancakes? Rugi. Nope. Dude, you are a nightmare. All right, blend this for me, please. Push. Thank you, bud. All done. All right, it's... No, you're not going to eat the flour. You weirdo. Ruger. Oi. Sick animal. You sicko. That didn't mix very well. Dude, what... A bloody pain this is. Ew. You are gross. I'm gonna have to give you a shower before we go in. Before I go and share you with Mum. Get down, please, Rugi. Sorry, Lila. Ruger, get down. Yeah, it's hot. Don't touch it, please. All right, we're on the last two. It's like doing something like this is really fun. It's meant to be really fun. And it's the memory that I think like you'll really enjoy, but it's hard work. Oh my goodness. Especially when you're a guy who can't bloody pour straight. Yeah? What do you need from there? There was another bottle around here, wasn't there? Yeah. Rugi, what did you do with the other bottle? What are you trying to get? A knife? Yeah. Yes, Ruger. What do you want? Can you put in some green, please, into here? Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Nice. Okay, let's put the lid on. You want to do, oh, blue. Good job. Okay, can you open it? Do you want help? Okay, come on in. Okay. No, dude. Leave that too. Oh, can you shake this for me, please? Hold on. Yeah. All right, shake. Shake, shake, shake. Oh, what the heck, dude? Keep shaking. What is it? Yeah. Okay, wait. Ruggie, can you squirt this in? Into this one. Into here. Good job. Okay, turn it around. Nice. You did it. All right, that is it for the colors portion. Wait, you need to put the, I need to put the lid on because you are a weirdo when you eat it without it being cooked first. All right, shake, please. Do you want butter with yours? Yes. Okay. Put that there, let me rinse these. Yeah. Whole. You're gonna make the best pancakes ever. Nope. No. Dude, I know what you're about to do. Okay, stop. Let me wipe that up and then we'll start making them. You know what is absolutely nuts is, unless the kid is just really well behaved, you know, see these videos of like family content creators making videos with their kids and it just looks like a really nice fun time. This is, it's fun, but it's, you know, it's also like, kinda wish I didn't do this. Yeah. You want a knife? Yes, just what all boys want. At least you know your dad's English. Go ahead and grab it. Okay, good job, bring it up. Okay, remember, we don't touch this, do we? Let me get some butter. I bought my wife this, I forget what it's called now, but you put butter in it. And then, so it's like a bell. You put butter inside the bell, don't touch. And then, that way you don't just have it like exposed. What, do you want to do some? Okay, don't whine, but. She didn't like it too much. I think she prefers this, like, whatever method this is. Good job. Oh, that's it. We don't need any more. We're just gonna wrap this around. Yeah. Don't touch, Ruggies. Remember, that's hot. All right, let's make these pancakes. They're gonna be absolutely atrocious. Ruggie, we don't need any more butter. Oh man. All right, leave this here, please. Get that out of the picture. Tilt this a bit. And then, do you want to spray? You want to spray some of yours? Okay, all right. Cool, all right. You're gonna turn it over and you're gonna squeeze. Oh, cool. You wanna do some green? Go on then, there you go. Nice. What about, oh, some blue? Those are like, go on then, you can do it. Good job. Well done. You want, no, let's get some other colors. You wanna do these two? Oh, look how good that looks, Ruggie. Honestly, mate, this looks terrible. You're just pouring it into the nice. Ruggie, these look great. What about some pink? Well, there we go. Okay, we're gonna stretch a bit further now, okay? We're gonna go all the way over here. This is a huge pancake. Good job. All right, that's it for now. Look at your pancake. Whoa. Remember, don't touch, because it's going to be hot. What an awful looking pancake. Are you excited to eat it? Yeah. Let's have a normalish looking one. Oh, wait. Yeah, but we've already used that, haven't we? Well, well, well. I knew it would look bad. I didn't expect it to... You want more? Okay, hold on. Change where this is. All right, remember not to touch. Oh, gosh. Yeah, hold on. Okay. Do you want to squirt some more? Let's do green. Squirt just there. Just here. But remember not to touch. Nice. Doesn't that look cool, Ruggies? Yeah. More. What colour do you want? Pink? Good. Manly man. Nice. Okay, that's enough. Okay, just keep going. You're contaminating your...
No.
Okay, wait. Let me check these.
Pink.
Yeah, I'll get you some more. Hold on, remember not to touch.
Pink.
Do you want me to plate yours up? Oh dear. Yeah, is that your plate? I don't know if that's done yet, actually. Yeah. Oh, yeah, looks done. That, Ruger, what a masterpiece. That one's really nice. Are you going to enjoy that? That's not done. Oh, that looks tasty. Try it. What does it taste like? Does it taste good? Do you want some chocolate chips in yours? Okay, here you go. So, you have to pick these and you have to put them in here, like this. Can you do that? Good job! All right, let's get some more butter. And then I'm gonna make one that actually looks good. I'm going to try to make one that actually looks good. Since using a griddle like this versus a pan for making pancakes, like because I make them all the time, I find it so much better. Like obviously my wife's a stay-at-home mum, so she does the majority of the cooking. But she finds this a lot more useful for the few times that we make pancakes. All right, Rugi, I'm going to do one blue eye, one green eye, and then we're going to do a mouth, but this dude's going to have some messed up teeth and no nose. Where's the yellow? And then he's going to have a dark blue nose. That is a brilliant looking pancake. I'm gonna have to show you that. Oh. Look at that. What do you think of my pancake? Does it look good? Does that look good? I'm not sure what that was, Rupert, but cool. I'm pretty pleased with. Oh gosh. All right, how is yours taste? Ruger. Oh, is that for me? Thank you. Okay, remember, Rugi, I'm going to get the maple syrup, but don't touch, all right? Because that's really hot. Don't touch.
Yeah.
He's at the point now. Lila, don't eat the chocolate. Got a dog down here trying to scavenge. He's at the point now. Is that for me? I'm pretty sure Lila licked it, but thank you. Yeah, he's at the point now where I think he has a pretty good understanding of what is hot and what isn't. So that he does and doesn't touch things. Rugi, that's a good looking one with your chocolate chips, isn't it? Oh, do you want to try that one? It's hot, mine, so be careful. Well, this, I'm going to say, didn't quite turn out as good as it first looked. Do you want a... What do you eat this with? Oh, yeah, it's messy. Nope.
No.
Yeah, it's messy. Messy, sada-bong, sada-bing.
Yeah.
What do you want? Chocolate chips?
Yes.
Okay. What did I do with them? Here they are. Okay, only a few, though. Yes. You want them just there?
Yes.
By the way, we don't make him pancakes very often, but he hasn't been with us for the past week. He's been staying with family, so it's kind of like spoil. Gotta spoil you. You spoil you. But I think we've eaten eggs every morning for the past 9 months, haven't we?
No.
No, no more chocolate chips. Do you want some syrup? Where do you want your syrup? On your pancake? Okay, and how do you, so Shay and I, we use a knife and fork and we'll cut our food. How do I show you? Like, the fork goes in and then you cut and then you obviously eat off of that. And the American style is more like you just use a fork and cut everything. And he's obviously not able yet to use a knife and fork properly. So do you want to use your fork? I'll just cut it for you. Do you want to try some? Try some with your chocolate chips. It's like when you get to this point, when it's like most of the work is done, now it's fun and enjoyable, but getting up to that point, it's so much effort, but I'm sure it's something that he'll enjoy over time. Well, if he remembers it, probably won't remember it. Thank you, Ruga. Do you want to use a fork?
Yes.
There you go. More syrup? Dude, you've got lots here. Dip in there. Let's get this out of the way. All right, what do you think, Rugis? My turn. Give me that fork. All right, once we see what my verdict is, I'm gonna turn the video off for now and then we'll just enjoy lunch together. I thought my pancake was gonna be so promising. You can't even see it from one side, and then the other side, he may as well have made that. Is it good, Rugi? I bet you, Rugi, I'll run a bet with you. I bet you I can't fit this whole pancake in my mouth and eat it and finish it. How much do you bet me? I'll bet you 4,000 rubles that I can do it. I don't think it was cooked all the way.
Yeah.
Yeah?
It's all stuck in my teeth because it wasn't cooked. While we were at Walmart, I'm just gonna cover my mouth. While we were at Walmart, I'm sorry, it's like I'm wearing a gum shield across my teeth. While we were at Walmart, I had a look at some of the like fun science experiments that I mentioned I could do. One of them looks really cool. It makes like crystals in the water. But I already have a couple downstairs. We'll try those first and see if he's into them. I bet those will be hard work to do with him, but I'm still looking forward to it. It's like if you forget about any of the stress involved in this, like who cares about the mess? Who cares that I now have to change him again? Me, obviously, but... All right.
Dad.
You have some. Oh, it's a chocolate chip. I'm going to go and switch over with Shay at the hospital for a good few hours. And I don't know if I'll film there because I'll probably spend the whole time in the room with Covey. So I probably won't film again until this evening. Like after I've put him down to sleep. Unless we have time to do something fun. You want some water? Okay. All right. See you in a bit. Ooh, bro, I am, is this even on? Is this even on? I don't know if it's even on. I think it sounds like it's on. I am donezo. I didn't realize, oh, let's get noise cancellation. I didn't realize earlier that my wife and I were switching for the rest of the evening. I thought she wanted to stay here in the evenings to be with the little man. Like, not that I, you know, think that's bad or whatever that we switched. But we have switched, and I've been here. It's now like 7:38. Been looking after him. I can't bring myself to come back here and just... Like, I'm all for taking care of yourself. But I can't bring myself to come back here and just kind of like chit chat or whatever when, you know, the little man's in there working his way through things. He is in a really good place, and maybe like it's getting closer and closer to this place of placing a higher priority on like myself and my wife. Which I know is like a... I get, how would I explain what I'm thinking right now? When something like this happens, you don't think about yourself. You just think about caring for them and doing what you can and being there for them. And, like, obviously the things that you hold dear, like your mental health, your physical health, like you just put those off to the side for a little bit, like while you focus on the thing that is the most important. But then slowly, as things get better and things improve, you start to be able to take a chance to focus on you. And so we're getting back to that place now. So I'm able to like hit the gym in the morning, able to get some work, hobby stuff done, which is quite nice. But at this point, I don't know if I'm sharing this because I want you to see me in a certain light, but Dustin and I have been working on some like day in the life type videos. I say we've been working on it. Dustin's been doing the majority of the work there, and he's done a piece here, so I'm going to check it out. I'm like dead tired. I could probably go to sleep right now. It's only 7:52. But number one, I do want to look at this work that was done, what Dustin's done. But I also feel like even if I didn't want to, I would like out of respect, I should take the time to look at what's done. I don't know why I really shared that. It's kind of a weird thing to share. Taking off the noise cancellation because there's no noise to cancel. Like I may not be perfect, obviously, but I do think I didn't even know what I was trying to say there. I think being respectful is high up there on my priority list. And I may not get it right every time, but I try to. So, yeah, it's quite cool how we've been doing this. So, Dustin, normally I've been shooting day in the life footage and then I upload it to a Google Drive and he's taking it down and kind of like messing around with it, playing with it and creating something. And he's been editing it in Final Cut Pro and then sending me an XML file. So as long as I have the same footage with the same like titles, the same names, I can just import the XML file and I see the timeline. So I see all the work that he's done. So that's what we've been doing. So I'm just hoping that the hospital Wi-Fi is good enough that I can jump in and see that. But interestingly, the I uploaded two videos to TikTok today in a slower paced, more conversational style, more personality type of style. And this is, I don't feel dejected or whatever, because what the hell. But it's a very interesting way to look at this. So the video has been up for 10 hours. It's got 2,000 views. The video is 117 seconds long. The average watch time is 11 seconds. And less than 2% watch the full video. So essentially, what you're seeing is, like the first few words say that my child is in intensive care, is in intensive care. But this is a real good indication, especially this graph. Are you gonna sort yourself out? I'm just about to see it. This is a real good indication of how little of a community I've been able to build up on TikTok over the past few years, because I've been doing that cold creator type of content, not realizing that it's been cold creator type of content. And one of the results of making this type of content is that you have to be posting viral type of content, but you have to be posting catchy content to get people's eyes each time. People aren't watching your content because they want to watch you in that content. Which is what I've been trying to do the whole time. I just have been doing it wrong. I don't look at this, the stats from that video, and think, oh gosh, no one cares about me. What am I going to do? I think, why is this so sticky? It's more like validating my thoughts in that area. Which, I mean, yeah, it all sucks, but it's good to know what the problem is, right? So we'll see how. I think I'm just going to keep pushing on it. See how it goes. All right, I'm going to look at this. Folders. Yeah, I'm gonna check this out. See what's popping, and then I'm gonna hit the hay. But the way things are going with the little man, tomorrow's gonna look like it's a big move. Based on where things are, big improvement for tomorrow. Okay, let's call it here. Night, night.